Please welcome Lifebox.
Lifebox enables richer and more genuine digital conversations. And conversations are kind of the key, right? If you've ever paid attention to your digital conversations, you may realize that they're not really conversations at all. You're either kind of yelling into the noise of social media, competing for the attention of people who don't really give a shit what you have to say, or you're sharing these kind of ephemeral messages about things that don't really matter, right? It's kind of an interesting phenomenon if you think about it. We're now over 10 years into unprecedented social innovation, yet no technology has been able to recreate the type of dinner table discussions that you have at home, those rich, meaningful discussions. And I'm really proud today to introduce you to a product that I think does just that, and that product is called Lifebox. And Lifebox is your daily moment of reflection. For users, it starts with a single question. And that question could be about anything from your childhood or your love life to your opinions on current events. And today's question is, what seemingly minor moment ended up having a major impact on your life? And my answer to this question is actually the reason that I'm here today. I live a pretty insane life. I have three children. I run a startup, so certifiably insane would probably be the most accurate way to describe me. And the way I've managed that is through a little tradition I have with my father-in-law, where every so often we hit the pause button on life, pour a few glasses of whiskey, and just reflect. And those moments are incredibly, incredibly powerful. And they always make you feel a little bit better about the world when you're done. And I'm guessing everybody in this room right now probably has their own version of this in their minds right now. And the idea that we could digitize those and enjoy them had a major impact on my life. So once I answer, I can share with the community or I can keep it private, but there's a catch here. You can't access this great conversation that's going on until you answer the question. And there's something beautiful in that, because your answer is forced to be a little bit more authentic and unique. You can't be swayed by the conversation that's already happening within Lifebox. So once I'm in, I can comment on people's answers to engage in a rich discussion, or I can vote for my favorites. At the end of each day, the answer with the most votes is pinned to the top, and its author is rewarded with greater influence on the next day's question. It's really an ongoing conversation. What's really interesting about this is that clearly our focus is on enabling a rich dialogue. It's on kind of bringing the digital conversation to a much more genuine, real place. But every answer that you create on Lifebox is in itself a really valuable thing. It's a really valuable piece of information. You're sharing an opinion, a perspective, a story about your childhood, perhaps. What we do at the end of each day when the question closes and we move on to the next one is we take that answer and the discussion that happened around it and we log it in your profile. And this quick, you know, few minute moment of reflection that you enjoy each day and you enjoy in a social way, over time becomes a really rich index of your perspectives and stories. And it becomes essentially your life story at some point. So that's Lifebox in a nutshell. In some ways, the largest dinner table discussion, or I guess, for me, a virtual glass of whiskey with the world where we can exchange stories and create something of permanent value online. I'd like to invite everybody in this room to log into mylifebox.com and answer today's question. You can also do that on our Android app. Yeah, that's it. If you'd like to connect with me, you can find me at adam@mylifebox.com. Thank you very much.
Okay, terrific. Kobe, why don't you start the question?
So does everyone on the app get the same question, or so how do you choose the questions, and how can the community maybe like they have the kind of subgroups and have their own sort of threads and stuff? How do you think about that?
So right now we're brand new. So everybody gets the same question every day. It's a really kind of broad discussion. Over time, as we scale, the idea will be to segment our audience into really relevant segments. So imagine, you know, if we're able to determine through our data in the background that we have this group of veterans, right? To be able to ask them specifically, this group, how has being a soldier changed your life, those types of things. We see this not only on our end with intelligence segmenting the audience, but also you doing it yourself. The next step for us will be to enable things like group questions. So you can choose or create your own question, send it to just your family and friends, and discuss amongst yourselves. Kind of like different tables when you walk in.
Yeah. Really interesting. I like how you kind of do this like gamification aspect of it, where it really kind of makes it a little bit more sticky and you know, empowers people to want to answer and get upvoted. So that part I think is pretty crucial. I'm curious about though how do you avoid users suffering from like the inertia of answering questions like every day and keep them coming back on a regular basis beyond this kind of gamification piece?
I actually think it's a really human thing. It's a healthy thing, right? So there's an interesting thing about people. We're not naturally introspective. Even if you think you are, for the most part, you're not. And there's been an interesting study I'll share as quickly as I can. The University of Virginia took 400 people, and they put them in a room for 15 minutes each and said, hey, your only job here, we're taking away your phone, distractions, is to think about life. The only other option they had was an electric shocker. And 66% of men and 25% of women shocked themselves. And the really interesting thing that came from this was the fact that when people are left to think about their lives, they go down weird places. They think about negative things. My next bills are due here. I have this appointment there. What we've been able to do with Lifebox is, questions are a very purposeful thing because they guide you down memory lane. They kind of bring you to a positive place to look back on your life. So to answer your question, if we do this right, every day, your question with Lifebox is going to be something you look forward to because it's a break from reality.
Okay, so this is more or less like a therapy play to some extent?
It's a therapy play. It's a place to compare your answers to other people, see how you compare to, you know, someone, potentially a family member, or someone you don't know at all. I mean, one of the interesting goals we have is to move the needle. So if you were to rate your relationships with, say, your sister or brother on a scale of 1 to 10, if you're being really honest, you may say it's a 4 or 5. Our goal is through this process to create that 7 or 8. It's really to bring people together around meaningful things, create meaningful content that's worth preserving online.
Okay. So I really like this. I like a lot of aspects of it. The thing that seems really obvious to me is you should give people the ability to preview and to consume this content, because I think there's going to be a lot more consumers than creators in this. And I think, you know, you're playing on a bunch of things, including like the rise of mindfulness. And I think people are very much wanting to be introspective in a very positive way, as you're mentioning. I'm also thinking that there's probably a lot of media partnerships that you can produce here. So again, I think thinking about how much creators versus consumers are participating in this ecosystem is going to be critical.
And that's a really great point, because we actually have, you can see yesterday's thread. So you can see the question and how people have interacted. So you can be a voyeur. You can go in there and kind of see the thing, but you can't interact. The idea with how we're modeled is that you must be a participator. We don't have spectators at the dinner table, right? We're all going to be at Thanksgiving next week, and you're going to go around the table and have these discussions, right? And you're not going to be a wallflower. So what we're pushing for is to really do the same thing here. So you can see a little bit from the day before. You do have to participate to get engaged with the current day. That's how we work now, and that's actually been, if you go in, you'll see some of the answers. They're pretty rich. I mean, you have to, that's what I love about it, too, because you have to engage uniquely. You can't be influenced by other people.
The other cool thing, I think, is this is a very sort of easy entry into blogging, which I think a lot of people sort of get stuck over that hurdle of what do I write about, and these become kind of conversation starters.
We joke that we're the diary for people who can't diary. It's a difficult thing to do, but if you do a little bit every day, you'll get somewhere.
That's a good way to put it, yeah.
Okay. Big round of applause for Lifebox.
Thank you.